Throughout history, stockings have been a part of fashion and culture in many countries, leading to the development of different types of fabrics used to make stockings, each with its unique characteristics. From the wool-based stockings worn by ancient Greeks to the silk and nylon varieties popularized in the 20th century, this video will explore the history of stockings. Stockings are a type of hosiery that have been around for centuries. They are typically made of nylon or silk and can add a touch of elegance to any outfit. Stockings have a long history dating back to ancient times. The first known stockings were made of animal skins and were worn by Native Americans, who used them to protect their feet and legs from the cold and rough terrain. In ancient Egypt, both men and women wore leg coverings made of leather or cloth. In medieval Europe, stockings were a sign of wealth and privilege, as they were often made of expensive materials like silk and decorated with elaborate designs. In fact, in some cultures, such as Scottish Highland dress, stockings are still an essential part of traditional attire for both men and women. By the 16th century, stockings had become an essential part of fashion for both men and women in Europe. Women's stockings were typically made of silk or wool and were held up with garters or tied directly to their corsets. Men's stockings were often made of cotton or wool and were also held up with garters. The invention of the knitting machine in the 18th century allowed for the mass production of stockings, making them more affordable and accessible to people of all classes. In the 20th century, advancements in technology and materials led to the creation of new types of stockings, including nylon stockings, a miraculous synthetic fiber, revolutionized the fashion industry. Skin-colored stockings, invented around 1935, successfully replaced silk, stopping imports from Japan, the number one producer of natural fiber. The first sales were made in 1940 in America, when over 4 million pairs were sold out on the first day. The invention of nylon is credited to Wallace Hume Carruthers, a chemist in DuPont's laboratories, as well as his assistant, Julian W. Hill. In the early 1920s and 1930s, the two worked in the American company studying polymers. Hill used a cold method to obtain polyester, which Carruthers later used in 1934 to develop polyamide, later called nylon, and patented by DuPont in 1939. During World War II, silk stockings became scarce due to the use of silk for parachutes and other military purposes, leading to a surge in the popularity of nylon stockings. This led to the nylon riots of 1945, where women lined up for hours to purchase the coveted stockings. To simulate the look of nylons, some women used leg makeup from cosmetics companies such as Max Factor. These liquid stockings were reported to last up to 3 days if the woman didn't bathe. If possible, a seam was painted down the back of the leg with an eyebrow pencil by a friend or family member, or by using a Y-shaped device to guide the pencil. In 1967, the British company Pretty Polly first used the term hold-ups on their self-supporting stockings. Their hold-ups were made with an elastic or silicone band and did not require garter belts to stay up. This idea was revolutionary. For centuries, a woman's only option was to wear pantyhose or struggle with the inconveniences of garters and suspender belts. With hold-ups or thigh highs, there was no unnecessary hassle of garter clips or ties. After Pretty Polly's product release, the word hold-ups became a generic trademark for this stocking style. Now that thigh highs were popularized, women could avoid the frustrating bumps that using garter belts created under a skirt or dress. Women could finally have it both ways. They could wear the stockings they loved and be free from garters. Thigh highs were further improved with the invention of lycra. The research into a stretch synthetic fiber to replace rubber went on for years before a DuPont chemist named Dr. Joseph Shivers invented fiber K in 1958. Released with a name randomly generated by a computer, the new LYCRA fiber could stretch so much more than the rubber that inspired it. This new spandex, elastane, fiber could be spun into fine filaments, stretched up to 500% of its original length, and best of all, always, return to its original shape. Always adaptable, lycra fiber began to make its mark in the world of fashion during the 1960s. Today, stockings are still popular as a fashion accessory and come in a variety of styles and materials, including nylon, silk, and sheer fabrics. They are often worn with garters, but can also be held up with adhesive or silicone bands. Whether for fashion or function, these garments continue to be a part of our modern wardrobes, with new styles and materials constantly emerging. Did you learn anything new from this video? If so, and you want to discover more uncovered facts from around the world, please like, subscribe, and leave comments about what other subjects you would like to learn more about.